I'm here with Sylvia Crowley at the Spring Fling 2 tournament at Disney's ESPN Wide World of Sports. Thank you for doing the coaches clinic earlier. It was great.
Oh, we enjoyed it. We got a chance to talk to AAU coaches, and I think it's a good merger, you know, just to interact with AAU coaches and them interact with us. And there were also some players in the stands, and so what an incredible opportunity that they get to kind of hear a coach's perspective on what we're looking for in players, as well as witness the game tonight, and maybe if they're lucky, actually get to meet some of the players and get an autograph tonight.
Kind of jumping on that, what do you look for in players, especially those that are coming out of AAU?
We look for players that are fundamentally sound, just because there's no substitute for the fundamentals. So, you know, we're looking for players that can shoot well, handle the ball, box out, rebound, drive to the basket. And so I think the women's game is very fundamentally sound as opposed to the men's game. But those are things that we're looking for in players. And we're counting on AAU and high school coaches to actually teach that before they get to college and then ultimately to the WNBA on a professional level.
And I know you mentioned in the clinic that you look for multidimensional players. Can you kind of explain what that means?
Well, we look for players that can do more than one thing, and if you can play several positions, then that gives coaches more flexibility to play you in different positions. That makes you harder to guard. That gives the players more opportunities to be on the floor and play the entire game if they choose to and if they're in shape to do that. But it starts, you know, just kind of on the high school level, being able to do more than just shoot. A lot of players just kind of focus on scoring because then they're in the newspaper and people are patting them on the back. But we look for those people that can dive after a loose ball, who could take a charge, who can rebound, who can set good screens, who talks on defense. And it makes you a more well-rounded player, you know. And so what it does is it forces the coach. It puts pressure on me as a coach to have you in the game. So that's why sometimes as a player, you can miss some shots and the coach will take you out. And somebody else misses shots, but they don't take them out. And you don't understand, why did they let her play and they didn't let me play? Well, that player is multidimensional. Even though she's not scoring, we still need her on the floor because she's getting rebounds. She's getting defensive stops. She's talking on defense. Our offense can't run smoothly without her because she remembers the plays. And so that's why it's important to be multidimensional as a player.
How do you think playing AAU can help those players once they get into the WNBA or in college ball?
Well, ultimately, when you're doing that many things well, coaches will see that you can handle more than one position. And so now you may play small forward, power forward, and even center position. You know, there are several players in the WNBA who can play at least two or three positions, but most can play two different positions. And so there's so many injuries that happen. It's such a long season. So if someone goes down and someone's not playing, then coaches aren't really freaking out because we can shuffle and move players to different positions. And it's really a luxury for us as a coach.
Okay, last question. What do you think is the hardest transition from going to AAU or college ball to a professional level?
That's three different levels. The biggest difference from going from AAU to college is that everyone is a star. You know, on your AAU team, you may be the only star. There may be two stars, but when you get to college, everyone was a star on that team. And so there can only be five starters, and the rest will sit the bench. And the people who are on the bench were stars in their AAU teams. And so it's really hard to accept and embrace your new role. It's a different level. People are stronger, they're quicker, you know, they're faster. And then once you've played on a collegiate level and you get drafted to play on a professional level, you start that all over again. It's kind of like being a freshman all over again. You know how you go through school and you're an eighth grader, so you're at the top of the school, and then you go to high school, now you're a freshman, and you're the low man on the totem pole. It's the same way within basketball. You know, on a professional level, the transition is tough because there's no more team concept. This is your job. So right now our rookies are going through that transition because we don't have a pregame meal like they had in college where everybody eats together, you get your carbs, you get your fruits, and you get every food group. Well, now as a pro, you get per diem. Here's your money. Be on the bus at 6 o'clock. We're going over to Disney to kick some butt. You know, it's so different. In college, you lift weights as a team. You have your partner and you lift weights. They spot you. On a pro level, you got 10 lifts this month. You don't get them in, we fine you $1,000. And we don't care if you do two lifts in one day. Get it done, you know. If you need more conditioning, get out there and run on your own. Whatever you need, like, you're a pro, you're expected to do it, versus college where people just kind of assisted you in everything that you needed. Totally different concept and mindset that you have to play on a pro level.
Well, thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.